Hello dear student, up to now I uploaded video lectures on the topic electrostatic potential and capacitance. Nearly on this topic I uploaded several lectures. Please watch that previous lectures for better understanding. Today I am going to discuss the most important topic in electrostatic potential chapter. So please watch the lecture till the end. Definitely you should love this lecture. So please observe carefully. Electric potential due to solid sphere. This is also called as non-conducting sphere. This is also called as a non-conducting sphere. A non-conducting sphere. This is also called as non-conducting sphere. Or a insulating sphere. Electric potential due to non-conducting sphere, insulating sphere and solid sphere. Okay, so please observe carefully. This is called a solid sphere. Solid sphere means charges are present inside solid sphere. Charges are distributed inside a solid sphere. Charge inside is not equal to zero. Okay. Now, first of all, write a general formula. E inside formula, inside of solid sphere formula. 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught into Q into R by capital R cube. This is E inside formula. E surface formula 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q by capital R square. E outside of the solid sphere. E outside of solid sphere. Electric field formulas I written. We are already discussing this electric field formulas. Electric field inside formula 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught into Q into small r by R cube. Electric field on the surface formula 1 by 4 pi epsilon into Q by capital R square. Electric field outside formula 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught into Q by small r square. So these are the formulas. So we are based upon these formulas, we are finding potential inside, potential on the surface, potential outside. So now, first one, case one, the point lies outside of solid sphere. The point lies outside of solid sphere. That means small r is greater than capital R. Small r is greater than capital R. This is called radius. Radius of solid sphere. What is the radius of solid sphere? Capital R. Point lies outside. That means here is the point I consider. Distance from center of solid sphere. Center of solid sphere to point is called. Here this distance is. We are taking small r. So now here observe carefully. We know that V is equal to. Electric potential V is equal to integral E bar dV is equal to minus integral E into dr. This formula already you know, because already we discussed so many concepts based upon this formula. Okay, observe now. So from this, integrating on both sides. This is integrating from. Let us consider point is moves from infinity to P. That means limits are infinity to P. We are doing integration with respect to R. That means limits we consider for R. At infinity, distance is we consider as infinity only. At P, distance is R. Am I right? So now, apply. Integral dV means V from infinity to P is equal to minus integral infinity to R, E outside formula, 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught into q by r square. From this, minus 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught into q integral 1 by r square into dr. Limit is infinity to r. Infinity to r. Am I right? So now observe carefully. Minus q by 4 pi epsilon naught integral 1 by x square into dx, 1 by x, r square into dr, formula minus 1 by r, that means infinity to r. So finally, if you apply this, then we'll get v on this side, vp minus v infinity. You know that vp value, vp only, v infinity value is 0, upper limit minus lower limit. So finally, Vp is equal to what we got? 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught into q by r. So this is electric potential outside. Electric potential outside. Outside of a solid sphere is inversely proportional to r. This is case 1. If the point lies outside of solid sphere, then electric potential outside formula 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught into q by r. What you observed from this, ma'am? Previous case, in hollow sphere, point lies outside formula. In solid sphere, point lies outside formula, both are same. Are you observed this thing? For hollow sphere, point lies outside formula. For solid sphere, point lies outside formula, both are same. Here also 1 by 4 pi epsilon into q by r. There also 1 by 4 pi epsilon into q by r. So I hope all of you understood this. Next we are going to discuss case 2. Case 2. Case 2. Case 2. Next case 2. The point lies on the surface, that means small r is equal to capital R. Here also for solid sphere, here the node point is, main node point is, for solid sphere and hollow sphere, electric potential, electric potential formula on the surface and outside of spheres is same. For solid sphere and hollow sphere, electric potential formula on the surface, outside of the spheres is same. Are you got my point? V inside hollow sphere is equal to V inside solid sphere. Sorry. Inside, not surface. V surface solid sphere. V outside hollow sphere. V outside solid sphere is same. So if you draw the V versus R diagram also, in both hollow sphere V versus R diagram and solid sphere V versus R diagram, both are similar. Next. Case 3. This is very, very important. Case 3. This is very, very important. Please observe carefully. Case 3. case 3, point lies inside of solid sphere. Point lies inside of solid sphere. For example, this is a solid sphere. Here is some point P lies inside, which is situated at a distance R from the center. Charges are present inside. Okay, charges are present inside. Now, radius is capital R. Now observe carefully, what is the formula for finding? dV is equal to minus E into dr. Integrating on both sides, dV is equal to minus integral E into dr. So from that, we are applying, because E is equal to minus dV by dr. From this, we are applying this. From this, we got this. dV is equal to minus E into dr. Integrating on both sides, applying limits. So what are the limits here? We are moving a point from surface to inside. Surface to inside. Okay. And here at surface, we move a point from surface to inside. So surface to inside. At surface, R value is capital R. Inside, R value is small r. Now minus integral capital R small r. E value, E inside formula, 1/4πε₀ q into small r by capital R cube. 1/4πε₀ q into small r by capital R cube. So from this, observe carefully. Minus 1/4πε₀ q by capital R cube. We are integrating with respect to dr. That means remaining only r is a variable. Remaining all terms are constant. Take away 1/4πε₀ into q by r cube terms are here constants. We are integrating from r to small r. Here, which is a thing here, left small r into dr. Small r into dr. Here, integral dv means v, surface to inside. Now apply upper limit minus lower limit. V inside minus V surface. V inside minus V surface is equal to minus 1/4πε₀ into q by r cube. Integral capital R to small r into dr. So please observe carefully here. These derivations are very, very important. So focus well. These derivations are directly, they are asked as a 5 marks questions. So please focus well. So now, V inside, I want, you know, V surface is equal to minus 1/4πε₀ q by r cube, integral r means small r square by 2. Integrating from capital R to small r. That means V inside minus V surface is equal to minus 1/4πε₀ q by r cube. Substitute lower limit first and next after upper limit minus lower limit r square by 2. Now observe here, I want V inside. Is equal to this Vs also move that side. Vs minus 1/4πε₀ into q into r square by 2 into r cube. Next, minus into minus plus 1/4πε₀ r square by q into r square, how many times square? R times, then q by 2r. So So V surface minus 1 by 4 pi epsilon into Q into R square by 2R cube, 1 by 4 pi epsilon into Q by 2R. V surface formula, 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught into Q by V surface formula, Q by capital R minus 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught into Q into R square by 2R cube. Here plus 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught into Q by 2R. Q by 2R. What is the common thing here? Observe carefully. What is the common thing here? What is the common thing? So we need to take common. We should apply here common. And what is the common thing here? 1 by 4 pi epsilon into Q by R is common. Am I right? 1 by 4 pi epsilon into Q by R is there here. 1 by 4 pi epsilon into Q by R here. 1 by 4 pi epsilon into Q by R here. That means we can take here 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught. 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught Q by R as a common. Then we'll get 1 minus 1 by 4 pi epsilon into Q R square by. That means 1 minus Q by R as a common. That means what is left here? R square by 2R square. R square by 2R square is left. Next. 1 by 4 pi epsilon in here plus 1 by 2 is left. From this, 2 into 1, 2, 2 plus 1, 3 by 2. So finally, this is nothing but a potential at surface. Potential at surface into 2 into 1, 2, 2 plus 1, 3, 3 by 2. 3 by 2 minus small r square by 2 into capital R square. So this is a V inside formula. Very, very important. V inside formula. What is V inside formula we got here? V inside is equal to V surface into 3 by 2 minus small r square by 2 into capital R square. Very, very important. My dear, here the note point is electric field is equal to 0, but electric potential at a point electric field is equal to 0, but electric potential not equal to 0. This is also very, very important point. Okay. In multiple choice questions, we are using this. And finally, this is very important formula. V inside is equal to V surface into 3 by 2 minus small r square by 2 into capital R square. So, this is about case 1, case 2, case 3. Now, we will draw V versus R diagram for this this solid sphere. Then that is end of this lecture. End of this lecture. Like a hollow sphere, we will draw here V versus. Well, to continuing my lecture on electric potential due to solid sphere, already we discussed three cases. Case 1, the point lies outside of solid sphere. Case 2, point lies on the surface of solid sphere. Case 3, point lies inside of solid sphere. These three cases we discussed. We got the values also. V outside of solid sphere, 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught into Q by R we got. V inside of solid sphere, that is equal to Vs into 3 by 2 minus R square by 2 into R square. Okay. From this, if R is equal to 0, in this case R is equal to 0, then point lies at center of center of solid sphere. Point lies at center of solid sphere. We consider small r is equal to 0. Then what we got here? V center is equal to formula. Small r is equal to 0 means 3 by 2 into Vs. 3 by 2 into Vs. Okay, V inside formula, you know. V outside formula, you know. And V center formula, you know. And one more formula, V surface. What is V surface formula? V surface is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught. This is V outside. This is also right fully. V outside. Point lies outside formula. This is 1 by 4 pi epsilon into Q by R. So for this one, V is inversely proportional to R. Okay. Next, V surface 1 by 4 pi epsilon into Q by capital R. Then draw the diagram here. Based upon that, we draw V versus R diagram. Very, very important. Always potential taking on y-axis and distance is taking on. Distance R is nothing but what here? Distance from center to point. Here R means what? R means distance from center to center of solid sphere to point. Okay. So here V versus R diagram. V inside. Okay. V center is what? 3 by 2 into Vs. For example, this is R is equal to 0 position. Here R less than R position. Here R is equal to R position. Here R greater than R position. So R is equal to 0 means point at center. R less than R means point lies inside. R equal to R means point on surface. R greater than R means point lies outside of the surface. The point lies outside of the surface. Point lies outside of surface. Outside of solid sphere. Point lies outside of solid sphere. R is equal to 0. This is a Vs. This is 3 by 2 means 1.5 into Vs. At R is equal to 0, the point lies at center, that is equal to 1.5 into Vs. 3 by 2 into Vs is nothing but what? R is equal to 0 means point at center. Potential at center is what? 3 by 2 into Vs, nothing but 1.5 into Vs. Then, R is equal to R, this is Vs. At R is equal to R, that means potential at surface. Okay, potential at surface. You know that value also, potential at surface is equal to 1 by 4 pi epsilon naught into Q by R. This is a Vs value. So here to here, it will change like this. It will change like this. And potential outside is inversely proportional graph. Potential outside is, because you know that the potential outside V is inversely proportional to R. That's why we drawn here inversely proportional curve. For outside, V is inversely proportional to R. Okay, so this is a V versus R diagram. This is a V versus R diagram for solid sphere. Potential versus R diagram for solid sphere. I hope everyone understood this. Everyone understood this. These diagrams are very, very important. My dear students, please focus on these applications. Electric potential due to hollow sphere, electric potential due to solid sphere, and V versus R diagram for hollow sphere, V versus R diagram for solid sphere. These are very, very important. So please be focused. Okay. So thank you for watching my lectures. Prepare well. All the very best.